The last thing that we're going to talk about today is going to be solving absolute value inequalities. Inequalities. All right. So say you've got something like this. Say you've got x is equal to, absolute value of x is equal to 3. You know, hopefully you'll come out and you'll say, well, that means x is equal to 3, x is equal to minus 3, right? So you've got a plus and a minus. So basically you rewrite the whole thing just by itself, and then you rewrite it again with a minus in front. We're going to do something kind of similar here. So keep that in mind. And look at this. So say if I had absolute value of x is less than 3. And in fact, I'm going to write that in bold. Absolute value of x is less than 3. And say I also had absolute value of x is greater than 3. Okay. I'll kind of separate these a little bit. All right. Now, what you're going to do over here on the left is you're going to do exactly what you would have done before. You're going to write absolute value of x is less than 3. You're going to write it just as it stands. Then you're going to write it again, absolute value of x, whatever is in the absolute value sign, you write that, and then you flip the sign and you add a negative. Just like you did here, except you didn't flip the sign. Before, you would just rewrite it and add a negative. Now we add a negative, but we also flip the sign. And even though this might not necessarily make mathematical sense to you, it shouldn't be entirely unexpected, because every time we're dealing with negatives now, we're flipping the sign, right? So that's kind of what we're doing here, is we're flipping the sign when we have a negative number. All right, so we're going to do the same thing over here. Absolute value of x is greater than 3, so that means x is greater than 3. And then x is, again, flip the sign, less than negative 3. So less than a negative. Less than a negative. Good? All right. Now here's the deal. Whenever you have a less than sign here, the way that you join these two is with an and. And over here, if you have a greater than sign, the way you join these is with an or, all right? You join them with an and over here, and you join them with an or over here. And this might seem completely arbitrary, and it kind of feels that way, but it's not. So here's kind of how I remember it. Whenever I first learned union and intersection and or and all this stuff, I learned it backwards and sideways. Could never keep it straight. So this is how I think of it. It's like, I'm really short. So this is me. And then this is my kitchen, and this is how I feel. Like, the kitchen counter's, like, right here. And then all my cabinets are up here. And so, like, I say that, you know, I can't have anything that's, like, because, you know, the cabinets have, like, 3 levels. This is a terrible kitchen cabinet. And I'm actually not quite that short. But, you know, your kitchen cabinet, you've usually got 3 levels. Well, I have this thing where anything that I use, like plates and coffee cups and stuff, has to be on the bottom 2 levels because, you know, I'm short and I can't reach anything. So, like, all the pots and stuff like that that you use for cooking that I never use because I don't cook, those can all go on the top shelf. But anything, you know, like little glasses and stuff like that can all go down here. All right. So, remember the less than sign, and is picky. Right? The and is the picky one. And you have to meet this requirement. You have to meet this one. You have to meet this one. That's like me. I'm kind of naggy. So I always think about this as being kind of like me because I'm short and naggy. So for some reason, I don't know why, but for some reason, this just always made sense to me that the less than sign was like short because you're less than everybody else. You're shorter than everybody else. So I'm the picky person and I have to have everything exactly where I want it because otherwise I can't reach it. And then over here, you know, you've got my husband, who's like 9'12", something like that. And, you know, whenever he does this, he can reach anything. So that's how cool I am. You know, this is the kitchen to him. He's just like, oh, it's no big deal. I can reach it, blah, 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 blah. So, you know, he doesn't care, right? He's like, whatever, whatever, I can reach anything. So anytime you would say whatever, it's no big deal, that's going to be your union. That's going to be your or. One way or the other, I don't care. Okay. Does that make sense? I don't know if that helps or just makes it infinitely worse, but that's honestly the way I remember it is. Tall people, they don't care, and they can reach it anywhere you put it, one place or the other. That's fine. Short people like me, you have to meet all my requirements, or else I'm not gonna be able to reach anything in my kitchen. I'm super, super picky, so I'm the ant. That's probably completely off topic and doesn't really help, but I actually kind of hope it does a little bit. So, however you do it, you have to remember that if you've got a less than sign here, if you've got a less than sign here, you've got an and. If you've got a greater than sign here, you've got an or. And you got to keep that straight one way or the other. Okay, and the solutions are very, very, very different. Okay, so let's get rid of these guys here. Kind of anyway. Come on. Deleting myself. Oh no, deleting my husband. There we go. Okay. So now we've got x is less than 3, and we've got x is greater than negative 3. So we've got x is less than 3, and it's this one. X is greater than negative 3. Okay, so we've got 3 and negative 3. So x is less than 3 goes this way. X is greater than negative 3 goes this way. So how do I meet both of these requirements? If x has to be less than 3 and greater than negative 3. So remember, I look at where they intersect. This is where they intersect. When I see and intersect, and means where they intersect. Picky, picky, picky. You have to meet both my requirements. So that means my solution goes from here to here and includes everybody in the middle. So I go from negative 3 to 3. So we've got x such that x is between 3 and 3, right? Good. All right, make sure you understand this because over here, it's seemingly innocuous difference. Here's a less than sign, here's a greater than sign. But we, in fact, get a very, very different solution. Oops. Or, I don't care. Whatever. That's how it says. That's my little shrugging shoulders guy. There we go. All right. So we've got x is greater than 3. X is greater than 3. And then x is less than negative 3. So to make either of these guys happy, one or the other is fine. So the furthest left that we can go is over here. This is as far left as we can go. We can include this guy. We can go all the way to here. But can we go in this area? Can we go in here? No, the answer is no, because there's nobody has anything. This is hollow. This is empty. That's empty until we get to here. Then we can go again. Okay, so as long as we're in this area or this area, again, I'm using the word or this area, at least one person's going to be happy. And that's what it's all about. So we've got negative infinity to negative 3, or 3 to infinity. And that should be pretty much good enough. All right. So let's look at another example. I'll actually do something a little bit more fun now. So we can go all over the place with these things. And so we've got negative 2, absolute value 3x plus 5, absolute value plus 7, greater than or equal to negative 13. Again, we're going to do the isolate and destroy. You want to get the absolute value sign by itself first and then separate it out. So we'll subtract our 7s from both sides. And we'll divide each side by negative 2. When we divide by a negative, flip the sign. 3x and 5 is less than or equal to 10. Okay, now we'll split it. When you split an absolute value, use the last symbol before the split. So when you split an absolute value, use the last symbol before the split. So we're going to use this one. Even though this was a greater than or equal to, it doesn't matter because right before we split it, it was a less than or equal to. So that's the one we're going to go with. So we're going to have 3x plus 5 is less than 10. And over here we'll have 3x plus 5 is greater than or equal to negative 10. And since it's a less than sign, less than, it's kind of like short people like me and I'm picky. So picky means and. It's the intersection. Picky. All right. Then we go in here and keep going, making some progress. Divide both sides by 3. X is less than or equal to 5/3. And then I subtract my 5s. 3x is greater than or equal to negative 15. Divide both sides by 3. X is greater than or equal to negative 5. Alright, so I've got now 5/3. Remember, it's kind of like 1 2/3. It's about 1.67. So I'm just letting you know so you know where to kind of put it on the number line. If you've got these fractions, you kind of got to know where to put them. So we're going to put it over here at 5/3. X is greater than or equal to negative 5. Here's my negative 5. And so X is less than or equal to 5/3. And X is greater than negative 5. Greater than or equal to negative 5. We'll put that there. So less than or equal to 5/3 means I'm going this way. Greater than or equal to negative 5 means I'm going this way. My and means I'm super duper picky. So I have to meet everybody's requirements. Let me see where they intersect. They only intersect in this area. Negative 5 to 5/3. This here is where they intersect. Okay. So I'm going from negative 5 to 5/3. So my set notation is x such that x is between negative 5 and 5/3. Isn't that desperately exciting? Yes, I thought you would think so. So let's finish this off today and look at exactly one more problem before we can move on and do other super duper fun stuff. All right. So, let's try this one. This one looks really weird to get started. Absolute value 5 minus 2x. Like that. Alright, so 7 minus the absolute value of 5 minus 2x. So first of all, this is in the wrong order. We don't like things in the wrong order. So we're going to rewrite it in the order that makes us happy. We want to have the absolute value sign on the left. And my little monster is chomping the absolute value sign, so he's going to keep chomping the absolute value sign. So, and that's how we make sure that we twist it the correct way. So now I'm going to split this out. I've got 5 minus 2x is greater than 7. 5 minus 2x is less than negative 7. It's a greater than sign. It's a tall guy. Tall guys can reach anything. Like, okay, I don't care. Wherever you put it, one way or the other. One way or the other. Works for me. Alright, so I'll subtract my 5s, just go to town, solving these out, and divide both sides by negative 2, divide by negative, mean I flip my sign. Dum do 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 do. And again, you know, pause this and work these out on your own before you watch me do it. If I'm going a little fast for you, you know, try to solve it on your own first, because then it won't matter how fast I'm going because you'll already have it done. And that's what? Negative, positive, negative 12? Yeah, I think I did that right. There. I was talking and not paying attention. Divide by a negative means I flip my sign. So x is greater than 6. So I've got x is less than negative 1. x is greater than 6, negative 1, 6, this is an or. So I've got less than negative 1, greater than 6. So that means that if I just have to meet one guy requirements or the other guy's requirements, one way or the other, he's happy. One way or the other, he's happy, which means that I can do any of these, any of this over here. I can do any of this over here. But as long as I'm not in the middle, because nobody's in the middle here. As long as I don't touch the middle, everybody's happy. Or at least one guy's happy. One way or the other, somebody's happy. And that's what we're looking for. So in interval notation, we go from negative infinity to negative 1. Or 6 to infinity. And we're done! Yay! Wasn't that exciting?